In this video, we're going to talk about using math to model the spread of an epidemic. So, newsflash, there's a measles epidemic running throughout the Austin, Texas schools. Well, what's going to happen next? We know how many kids are infected. We know how many kids were infected yesterday. We've got some data up to now, but what's going to happen next? Is everybody going to get sick? And what can we do about it? Those are important questions. So what we do, step one, is we have to make a model. We can't analyze all the details of thousands and thousands of kids and millions of germs. You have to make a simple model that's simple enough that you can handle it, but realistic enough to contain all the important features of disease spread. And this boils down to biology more than anything else. The second thing is you have to solve the model, and there, that's math. The third thing is this model involves some parameters, and maybe you discover that everybody's going to die, but if only we had a slightly smaller coefficient of such and such, then everybody would be saved. Okay, so you understand how sensitive your model is to the different parameters that went in there. And finally, you find ways to change the parameters. Maybe if we close the schools, we can reduce the transmission coefficient, and that will stop the epidemic. We'll talk about these real-world fixes in the next video after we've solved the model. In this video, we're going to pay attention to making the model, coming up with a realistic model that describes an epidemic. So this model is called the SIR model. SIR stands for susceptible, infected, recovered. See, we're going to basically treat kids as one of three classes. They're the susceptible children. That's the ones that are currently healthy. They've never had measles before. They're not immune. They could get sick at any time. If they come into contact with a sick kid, they're likely to get sick. Then I is the number of infected kids, the ones that already have measles. And finally, R is the number of kids that have recovered from the disease. Then they're immune, they won't get it anymore, and they're not going to get anybody else sick. So what we are doing is we break the population into these three groups, and we keep track at the rate at which the three populations change. So S prime is the rate at which S is changing, I prime is the rate at which I is changing, R prime is the rate at which R is changing. So if you measure S in people, S prime would be in people per day or people per week. And the model is that susceptible kids sometimes get sick. So sometimes you have to keep track of at what rate are susceptible kids becoming infected. And infected kids recover after a while. You keep track of the rate at which infected becomes recovered, and you put it all together and you get your equations. So the first step is actually pretty easy. We're going to assume that every day a certain fraction of the sick kids recover. Now this isn't entirely realistic because a kid that's only been sick one day isn't going to recover tomorrow, and a kid that's been sick for 2 weeks probably will, because measles tends to run for about 2 weeks. But we're simplifying. We're trying to get a model that we can actually solve, so let's just treat all of the infected kids the same, whether they got the disease yesterday or 2 weeks ago. And we'll just say, since measles runs for 2 weeks, let's just suppose that every day 1/14 of all of the infected kids recover. Okay, so that's one of our equations. The rate at which kids get sick is a little bit more subtle. See, it's proportional to the number of people who are susceptible. It's also proportional to the number of people who are already sick. Because what happens is every time a susceptible person meets an infected person, there's a chance that the infected person will give his germs to the susceptible person and make him sick. So the number of times that a susceptible person touches an infected person is proportional to the product of the number of susceptibles and the number of infecteds. I say proportional because there's a certain constant in front. We call that the transmission coefficient. So we say the rate at which kids get sick is some constant times the number of susceptibles times the number of infecteds. So the rate at which we go from S to I is A times S times I. The rate at which we go from I to R is B times I, where A and B are constants. And that means the rate at which S is changing, it's negative because people stop being susceptible. The rate at which I is changing is the rate at which kids are getting sick minus the rate at which they're recovering. And the rate at which R is increasing is the rate at which they're recovering. So here are our equations, and they depend on some parameters. To have the equations, different diseases in different cities and different conditions will have different values of A and B, but this basic model will work whether you talk about measles or smallpox or AIDS or any kind of disease. A is a transmission coefficient. It talks about how easy is it for the disease to spread from an infected person to a susceptible person. B is the rate of the recovery. So if somebody gives you the transmission coefficient and the recovery coefficient, you write down these three equations, and you've got a pretty darn good description of how the epidemic is going to run. In the next video, we'll talk about how to solve these equations.